Hi Aquarius, welcome to Omkara Tarot and to your June monthly reading. Please know, even though I'm doing your reading, I could be picking up on the energy of someone on your mind, someone who's attached to you, or even the cross watcher who's here checking up on your energy. Also know these readings are collective, so each and every reading may or may not resonate with you. So, you know, take what works for you and just leave the rest. Let's begin, Aquarius. Dear God, goddesses, angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Aquarius and send us the message they need to know. Thank you. So Aquarius, how's it going? Let's see what your energies are for the month of June now. First card will be your recent past, your current energy, upcoming. This is what you're holding on to or should hold on to. This is what you're meant to let go of this month. Your hurdles. This is how people view you. And this is advice from the universe. Two of Cups in reverse. If I remember, last month you were having a little problem with your significant other. Are you? I don't think there's any making up been done yet. The Emperor in reverse. Yes, Six of Cups in reverse. The King of Swords in reverse. Six of Pentacles in reverse. Seven of Swords in reverse. It's time to let go of whatever fight you're having, Aquarius. High Priestess in reverse, not listening to your intuition at all. Let's see how people see you. People see you with a broken heart. Aquarius, there was so much potential, if I remember, you know, of everything getting okay last month. What happened here? Why are you now, as you know, seen as the Empress in reverse? Why are you feeling like the Emperor in reverse? Feeling weak, feeling tired, not in control. Because your Empress is, you know, in reverse. I have a perfect match here. You people are meant to be, Aquarius. There's the Emperor and Empress in reverse. But the point is, you guys are the perfect match here. And you're both feeling lonely, sad, separated at the moment maybe. And just, you know, thinking of what you've lost in the past. Why is the Emperor and the Empress in reverse, Spirit? And why are they both feeling this sadness between them? Or at least the Aquarius is, definitely. But they're both in reverse at the moment. And the Two of Cups, bottom of the deck, is in reverse too. You were trying to manifest a new beginning, but somehow you haven't yet reached out and, you know, given your cup of love. What happened in the recent past? Let's see. Okay, two cards have fallen out. There was a lot of spying going on. You were trying your best to kind of get over whatever fight that happened. You really wanted to go back to the past, but I don't think either of you have taken the first step yet. Okay, in the past, even though you both felt it, and both wanted to go back to the past, you've just been spying on each other and not taking any action. Please give us another card. Sorry. Give us another card for the past position, please, Spirit. Please give us another card for the past position. Why is the Three of Cups in reverse? Still holding that burden. Aquarius, you're still holding on, or your cross watcher is. You're still carrying the pain and the burden of whatever happened in the past. You haven't let it go. And right now, in the present moment, the Emperor and the Empress are seen as reverse, and there's a Two of Cups in the reverse as well. Even though you both are the perfect match for each other, there's just stagnancy in the situation. Okay, stagnancy in what can be a beautiful relationship. You're meant to be. Look at the 11-11 card that you have. The Emperor, the Empress. And yet, things have come to a screeching halt. The King of Swords is in your future position, but in reverse. So, King of Swords is, you know, in... Oh God, even the Queen of Wands is in reverse. Both angry, still fighting. Total confusion here, wanting to know the truth, wanting to know what to do. Right now, both turning your back to each other. I don't know what to say, Aquarius. I really don't know what to say. There was so much potential here. See how much unhappiness? Both are unhappy, both are sad, but both not taking action at this time. What is it that Aquarius should let go of, Spirit? Why is the King of Pentacles in reverse? There was no equal give and take in this relationship, Aquarius. You know, somebody was breadcrumbing the other. There was not an equal amount of love or reciprocity being shown. So Spirit is saying this is what, you know, this is the pain that you're holding on to and you're feeling totally left out in the cold at the moment. Maybe both people are. Look at these two people who are out in the snow, in the cold, when, you know, there's a beautiful house, church, something with a fireplace inside, but they're choosing not to go inside. They're both struggling outside, in the snow, cold, hungry, but they're just not turning around to see that there is potential for warmth and, you know, happiness just behind them. You have to work together. You have to come together to work together on this. This holding on to stagnancy, holding on to pain is doing nothing. And the best part, again, I've got the same card. If you don't give out an apology, you're not giving out an apology and yet you want to go back to the past. Okay? This card has come out twice. Six of Cups in reverse, the Six of Cups in reverse. Now this is somebody from your past, definitely, who you are cooling off with. You want this, you want to go back, but nobody is taking action at all. What should Aquarius let go of, Spirit? Why is the Seven of Swords upright? Okay, now Seven of Swords is a card in tarot, which is normally the thief, the cheating person card. So Spirit is saying there'll be no happiness if you just people keep fighting with each other and doing underhand things. Okay, so let go of this behavior of trying to undermine the other one, trying to, you know, sneak around or not be honest with each other. So let go of this behavior if you want this Emperor and Empress. Emperor and Empress together is the perfect match. I can just keep saying that. Look at this Two of Cups here. Okay, again an equal match. This is also in reverse and Emperor Empress also in reverse. I mean, you're a match made in heaven and yet you're just holding on to the pain. Shutting your eyes, you know, you have swords over your heart to say, I'm not going to see, I'm not going to make a decision, I don't care, I don't care. You have to care, Aquarius. You both have to care. If you don't take a step forward, how are you going to solve this? You're not communicating with each other at all. You're not communicating with each other, and your main hurdle is you're not using your intuition. There's no talking happening, and that is going to be your biggest hurdle. Stop listening to your head now. Try, you know, you're not putting in any more investment. This is your biggest hurdle. You have to put in some more work in this. You can't just sit back, shut your eyes and, you know, feel you're all tied up and I'm not going to move. That's not going to work. Please give us another card for, King of Pentacles in reverse. Okay, so King of Pentacles upright is a king who's, you know, the the head of the family, who looks after everyone, nurtures everyone, who's responsible, but you're not willing to take responsibility, or maybe this is your cross watcher. Okay, somebody is not doing what they're supposed to do. They're just sitting under a tree and refusing to see the good that the divine is, you know, offering them. They're not even looking at that cup that's coming from the universe. Sitting in hanged man's position, not willing to budge. People see you heartbroken. Okay, so let's see, why are people seeing you like this? Yes, you are. I mean, I don't even have to clarify why. All these cards are, you know, right in front of me, and they're telling me that just because you people are, you know, maybe having an ego battle right now, you both are in limbo and you're not taking steps towards each other. You're not communicating with each other. Nobody's willing to put in any more work. Whereas this, you both are missing each other. You definitely are missing each other, because this is a Six of Cups and the Emperor, Empress and the Two of Cups relationship. This came out sideways, so this could be reverse, and in reverse it just shows that nobody is looking out to the future. Nobody is wanting to see what else is out there, what else, you know, is possible. And that's why you're sitting with a broken heart. Both have the defenses up. Right now, both of you have the defenses up, and you're both guarding yourself and fighting the fight till the end. Whereas I don't see there, you know, there to be any need at all. It isn't like, you know, it's like a fool and an emperor who's a combination here. This is the Emperor and the Empress right in the center of the deck. See, once again, the Empress and the Emperor, center of your spread. You can't have a better match than this. Last week, I remember, you know, there was so much potential. Just an apology had to be given. And I remember, if I remember correctly, it was, the caption was, sunshine and rainbows are back. But the advice even then was communicate and apologize. I don't think as of now, any of you have taken a step forward. So let's see what the advice from the universe is this time. Come out of this resting zone. Spirit is saying the same thing. Aquarius, one of you or both of you have to come out of this, you know, gone within and thinking and, you know, not communicating zone, and come out and reach out to the other person. This has become really imbalanced. Spirit is saying, you have to restore balance back into this relationship. There's no more balance left in this relationship, because both of you have taken time out, or at least you have, because this is an Aquarius reading. So this is either you or your other person. And yes, you're not taking any, you're not even thinking of charging ahead. Still not wanting this tower to fall though, okay? But you're not taking any action either. Wishes and hopes don't make a structure or a marriage or a partnership. You have to come this way. Start taking some action, because you right now are feeling totally like, you know, you're not emotionally happy. Because something blew up. You're holding on to that thought that you don't want this tower to fall, but you're not taking action. So Spirit, is there any more advice we can give? Two of Cups in reverse. What are you going to do about it, Aquarius? Who cheated? Who lied? Somebody snuck away doing something they thought they could get away with. And that's led to all this. So what can we expect, Spirit, now? Spirit is saying, if neither one of you will step forward to correct this now, this cycle will come to a close. Okay? There will be no rebirth, and there will be no restart to this, and this chapter may just come to a close, which is a pity, because this was a match designed by the universe. It was a perfect match because of your own, not taking action or just sitting back and not apologizing. If this gets delayed, Aquarius, this chapter may have to come to a close. There will be no rebirth. It saddens me, it really saddens me to do this reading, but I have to read the cards. I can't just call it rainbows and sunshine all the time. Especially when I see that, you guys are not taking action. The universe does give you free will. There is destiny and there is free will. You can't take a gift from the universe for granted either. Because if you do, it's over. Anything else, Spirit, for Aquarius? You have so much love for this person, or this person has so much love for you. Why are you keeping it hidden? The King of Cups manipulates the other person with his emotions. Even though he has a lot of love, he just doesn't show it. Emotionally closed, keeps secrets about how he feels. This is what one of you is doing, or both of you are doing, and that's what's, nobody wants to walk away from this either. Both of you don't want, why can't you tell each other? Please tell each other how you feel. Apologize, please. Let's take an advice card from the angels. Angels, please send us a card for Aquarius as to how they can be helped. Believe in yourself. Believe in this connection. If you believe in it and you know that you're not going to be rejected, you are not going to be turned away, is when you can win. If you are going to doubt this connection, Aquarius, if you doubt it, universe is listening to that too, right? First thing is to know what you feel and believe it in totality. If something has gone awry, and if you feel, you have made a mistake or they've made a mistake, just get together and talk it out. Otherwise, it's going to be the end of this relationship, which would be really sad. I've said that before. I've never seen such a perfect match of the Emperor and Empress, center of the spread with the Two of Cups, all reverse. Can I say anything more, Aquarius? Forgiveness. That's all that is required here. You need to forgive whoever's, harmed you or cheated you or manipulated you. If you have love for this person or that this person has love for you, you have to not only forgive yourself first, okay? If you made a mistake, first step is first to forgive yourself and say, okay, and accept what you've done. And then move ahead to the other person and, meet them halfway. Forgive each other and it can still be solved. I hope you take this advice, Aquarius. It burdens me to read a reading like this, where it was so beautiful and free will. And universe is now saying, if you don't do this, there will be a closing down of this chapter. There's no point living in regrets. Give it a chance, Aquarius. You're going to lose it anyway, okay? So at least try. Maybe there's hope. Maybe you guys can get back together. So I hope to have a better reading. I'm going to be doing love readings this month. If you haven't subscribed, please do. I want to meet up with you again and see where this is going forward. So till then, love and light. And please, please, please forgive, believe and make up. See you next time. Love and light.